Guys, how are you? So I have a makeup haul for you today. I have a few things from Sephora, a couple of things from Too Faced, and then a few shadows from ColourPop that I thought I would share with you. If you guys have any recommendations, definitely let me know in the comments below, because this is kind of a collective haul, so it's been a while since I purchased some of these things, but I just never got a chance to show you. They were kind of sitting in a basket on my bookcase and I forgot about a lot of them, but since I'm doing my beauty videos again, I thought I would share them in case you want me to do a review on anything, or you want to see anything in a get ready with me or something like that. So as always, if you have any recommendations, I would love to hear them. And let's jump into it. I'll show you guys what I got from Sephora first. Okay, so this first product is probably the thing that I'm most excited about, just because I've been wanting it for a while, but it's one of those things that I would walk past and I'd be like, I don't need it. But I finally decided to go ahead and get it for myself, since it was like the 10th time that I walked past it and I was like, I want it. So I just ended up picking it up. It is the Bite Beauty Watercolor Lip Gloss Library. Around this time last year, they came out with the Deconstructed Rose Lip Gloss Library, and I ended up purchasing it, and I love it. I wear those lip glosses almost every single day. They are just perfect for everyday wear because they're sheer, but they have a little bit of color to them, and I just love them. So I ended up purchasing this. This is really great because it comes with 12 different lip gloss shades, and Bite Beauty lip glosses can be a little bit pricey, so this is a great way to be able to try their product. I decided to pick it up because there were some really unique shades, a lot of like bright shades that are just perfect for spring and summer. And honestly, I haven't really played around with it a whole lot. I know a lot of you guys told me on Instagram you were kind of disappointed in that some of the shades are a little sheer for you. And while they do look opaque in the actual packaging, I feel like their glosses tend to be sheer, which I like just because I find that they're really perfect for everyday wear. So I'm excited to play with it. If you guys want me to do a review, I can definitely do that for you. I don't know how long this will be around because the Deconstructed Rose Lip Gloss Library was only around for a few months. So if you want to see a review, I can definitely do it, but I'm excited to play around with it. My husband actually bought me this next product, which was so sweet of him. I think it was either for my birthday or our anniversary, but I had mentioned that I really wanted this palette and he actually went to Sephora and got it for me, which was so kind of him. But this is the Tarte Lip Palette. It is Amazonian Clay Matte Shadows. I'm really looking forward to playing with this because it comes with 12 matte shadows, and I've really been loving matte shadows recently. I really like shimmery shadows too, but the shades in this palette are absolutely gorgeous. It has some really beautiful purple shades and then a bunch of neutral shades. So I'm really looking forward to playing around with it. I can't believe that I haven't used it yet. So if you guys have any favorite combinations with this palette, you'll have to let me know so I can try them out for sure. If you guys watched my May favorites, I mentioned that I've really been loving the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water, and it's amazing. I love it so much. But on the other hand, I also love the Smashbox Photo Finish just regular foundation primer, and I ran out. I was like using these little samples up and it's amazing. So I went and purchased the full size just because I love it so much. And you guys, I'm telling you, if you want like a full flawless face starting with your primer, definitely start with this one because it really just helps to even out your skin tone, kind of fill in any fine lines, any pores that you might have. And I love it. I think it feels so nice on the skin and it really just preps your face for foundation. If you want something a little lighter, I would definitely recommend the primer water, but if you really, really like full coverage, flawless, you're definitely going to like this. I picked up the Benefit Roller Lash because I picked it up when it first came out, I think, but a lot of people were talking about it, and now I can't remember if they were saying good things or if they were saying bad things. I can't remember. So I'm excited to try this out just because I feel like I'm going to be a little bit unbiased since I don't know if people love it or if they hate it, but this is supposed to be really great at curling and lifting your lashes, and my lashes do not hold a curl very well at all. It doesn't usually bother me because I do wear false lashes a lot of the time, so like it doesn't really matter because, you know, I have false lashes on, but I feel like when I'm not wearing false lashes, I kind of hate when they just start to like fall and they're not curled at all. So I'm looking forward to seeing if this helps. They said that like most people are saying it really helps to hold a curl and it helps to just lift your lashes. So I'm curious about it. I think the wand looks interesting. Got a Stila Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner. Now the one that I have has lasted me forever. Like it's seriously the never ending eyeliner, but I feel like one of these days it's just gonna like quit working on me and I'm gonna be like, I need my eyeliner. So I purchased this one because it is my favorite, It is my favorite eyeliner for creating a winged line. And it just, it literally stays in place all day. It's really easy to apply. It's super black and I just love it. If you guys are looking for a good liner, try this. You guys were the ones that told me about it and I love you for it because I just, it's my favorite. I wear it so, so much. I got a few things from ColourPop, which I'm excited about. I feel like there are so many things I want from ColourPop, but they just, I get overwhelmed when I go on their onto their website because there are just so many shadows I don't even know where to start. But if you guys have any lip recommendations, definitely let me know. I've only tried Frida, which Danny made, which I absolutely love. It's such a beautiful kind of pinky nude shade. And then I just picked up Lumiere, which is the one Kathleen Lights made. And I also love this one. It reminds me of NARS Anna, which I'm actually wearing today. And I've really just been liking pink shades like this. And so this one's really gorgeous. I love both of those too. But I would love to hear if you guys have any summer lip product recommendations just because they have a lot of gorgeous colors on the website and I don't even know where to start. So if you have some that you've tried and you really love, let me know in the comments below so I can check them out. I also picked up a bunch of eyeshadows from them recently. I have a few and I absolutely love them, you guys. They're really great quality products. My favorite is definitely Game Face. It is just the most beautiful eyeshadow of all time. If you guys only try one, definitely pick that one up. So let me show you the ones that I got. I got the color Sequin, which this is the only one that I've tried so far. It's a really, really beautiful, kind of like bronzy rose gold shade almost. It's really unique and I absolutely love this color. And then I also got the shade, what color? So Quiche. This one's interesting. I haven't tried it yet. It looks a little bit different than I thought it would be, but it's kind of like, I don't know, a cool toned brown silver with some green shimmer in it, which is probably not something I would normally wear. So I'm curious to see what this looks like. I'll definitely try it out and see how it goes. This one is Get Lucky, which is a really, really beautiful shade. I got this one because I thought it would be fun for spring and summer. It's kind of like a gold lime shade, but it's really beautiful. It's really unique. I don't own anything like this. I got the shade Ibiza, I don't know how to say that, but it's a really beautiful blue shade. Now, I'm not really a colored eyeshadow wearer, but I did pick this one specifically to kind of try something different for the summertime. I thought it was really gorgeous, so I can't wait to wear that one. This one is probably going to be one of my favorites for sure. I can't get these out of the box very easily. This shade is called On the Rocks, and this is just a really, really beautiful brown shade. It's definitely like an everyday neutral shade, kind of like what I'm wearing today, and I feel like I will get a ton of use out of this one. And then the last one I got is called Bandit, and this is a matte shade, I believe. I haven't tried any of the matte shadows yet, but it's just a beautiful, beautiful matte brown, and I can't wait to wear it. I feel like they just have so many shades that I don't know where to start. So if you guys have any recommendations, let me know for sure. I really like ColourPop eyeshadows. I know everybody is talking about them, but it's because they're such great quality and they're only $5, so I feel like $5 for a single eyeshadow is a pretty good deal, you know, especially because they're like high-end quality and I really like them. And then I did get a few things from Too Faced. They did send these to me, so I didn't purchase these with my own money, but I wanted to share them with you guys in this video to see if you wanted me to feature any of these in a review. I actually got a bunch of bronzers, which I posted on Instagram, so if you guys want to see a video, I was thinking about doing a video with swatches, kind of letting you know which one would be best for which use. So if you want to see that, I will do it for sure. But they also sent me the Better Than Sex mascara, which this is a pretty high claim, I feel like. So I'm curious to see how this is. It says that it gives you 1,944% more volume, which is crazy. So the before and after picture looks pretty crazy. I'm excited to try it. It will definitely be the next mascara that I try. So I feel like this has to be good. Like, its claims are ridiculous. They actually sent some of their Melted Liquified Longwear lipsticks my way, which I absolutely love. These are some of my favorite lip products. They actually made it into my 2014 favorites just because they are long wearing, they go on the lips so beautifully, they smell amazing, and they have a crazy color selection. Like, I remember when they just came out, I think there was like 4 or 5 shades, and then I went to Sephora the other day and there were a ton. So I'm so excited they sent me some of the shades that I don't don't have, which was just so nice of them. The first one is Melted Fig, which is definitely the most unique shade, I feel like, because it's really, really gorgeous purple shade, and I don't own anything like this. It kind of reminds me of like those dusty pink shades I like, but purple. So I'm excited to wear this. They also sent me Melted Marshmallow, which is just a really, really beautiful pink shade. It's just that perfect medium pink for spring and summer. Melted Berry, which is such a gorgeous color. It's just, it's kind of like my go-to fall lip color. So I love this. It's just dramatic and pretty. Melted Nude, which I love, especially with a pink gloss over it. If you guys haven't tried that yet, definitely try it because it's just a pretty unique nude shade. And when you wear it with a pink gloss, I think it looks so stunning. Melted Strawberry, which I am so excited about because red lips are my favorite, and this is like a hot red with some pink undertones to it, so I'm excited to wear it. I feel like it'll just be perfect for spring and summer. And then they sent me my favorite color of all time. I'm so happy because I actually lost mine, which was so sad. I could not find it anywhere. Melted Peony. I think this is like my absolute favorite lip product and color of all time because it's so wearable. It goes with every single look, and I love it. Last summer I wore it almost every single day, like that I was going out, and it's just so beautiful. I cannot get enough of it. If you guys try one, try this one because it just goes with everything you wear. So that is the end of my makeup haul. Thank you guys so much for watching. I would love to hear your opinions on these products or if you want me to do a review on any of them. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.